Hi there. I'm WB5YBZ. My name is Rich. And finally, Ham Radio Deluxe has a Panadapter. They have Panadapter main and they have Panadapter sub. Right now, I can't figure out how to get the Panadapter sub. But let's go in. We have to make some changes on the 7300. And we also have to adjust the speed of the Ham Radio Deluxe. Thanks for watching. Let's go on in and let me show you what changes I had to make. All right, let's just go in here. We have to hit menu. Go over here for your settings. Hit the connections. Hit the CIV. Go to the very top of your screen. And make sure you have it maximum, which is the 19200. That's the first thing, okay? Second thing is CIV USB port. You have to have it unlinked from remote. Mine was on link. And the third thing is right below it is the maximum speed on the CIV USB baud rate. Now I'm gonna go over this because I was telling a friend and he had some various ones changing. I'm gonna go all the way up the top and let's just check and see if this is what you have set up. CIV baud rates, 19200. CIV address is 94H, as in hotel. CIV transceive is on. CIV USB remote transceive address is at 00H, as in hotel. CIV output for antenna is off. CIV USB port unlinked from remote. That's one of the ones. This is the next one. Is CIV USB baud rate is 115200, and the CIV USB echo back is off. And that should get you going on this. One of the things I'm going to go over to the computer and we'll talk about that. When you start your Ham Radio Deluxe, over here is your different speeds. You might not have this when you first connect, but once you have changed your baud rate on your 7300, you have to sign on and change your baud rate to 15200. Once you've done that, well, I'll let it boot up. You go to Tools. You go to Panadapter. And there it is. Okay, one of the things about the Panadapter, same thing with your IC 7300, you can see a conversation or something over here. You can double click it and watch what happens. Watch what happens when you on the IC 7300 when I click it. I'm going to double click it right now. See, it went to 193. Now if I want to go down CW portion of the band, I'm hearing look like I'm seeing a station down pretty close to here. I don't know what frequency is, but I'm going to double click it. And there we go to 709. Now if I want to go back up here and see who might be talking on this peak, I can go double click it and it'll go back up to this frequency. It's close. Of course, that's a foreign station, wouldn't you know? This looks like something here. CW. That's on a higher. Undoubtedly, there's a contest going. But you can sort of see what you can do. Also, you can change the colors if you want to change, let's say, to a, I'm trying to think what, a burgundy. Let's go burgundy. And waveform background, let's say we're going to change it to a blue. And we can say OK. And there's a red and the blue. I think I like the yellow and the black better. Yellow. And then changes to black. And there you go. Another thing, you can also change some of these to different ones. 10 kilohertz for an example. You have a narrow, fast, and various other things. You can just play around with it and see what happens. If it's weak, you can always strengthen it up a little bit by adjusting this little knob here. And it seems like it has to reboot almost when it does this. The waterfall, I don't know if the waterfall earlier was higher, it seems like. I'm not sure. But anyway, it's sort of fun to just sort of play with different things and just see what you can do with everything, just to and then it seems like it sort of locks up in a way. And there it is. Anyway, you can play with it, but that's how to get the pan adapter to work. I haven't been able to work the sub. It has two options here. One adapter, pan adapter main, and then the sub. When I hit the sub, of course, it says your radio does not support the pan adapter, so I'm sure there's some type of adjustment that I don't know that I have to make yet. Thanks for watching. Hope this has been helpful.